project was about water recreation in Southeast Ohio as an eco-friendly alternative to the what has historically been the dominant industry of the state, which is heavy industry. Coal mining, timber cutting, brick production, things that by their very nature damage the environment. As those industries have dried up, people have been realizing that this part of the state holds resources of a different kind, the kind that can be used for recreation, canoeing, kayaking, ecotourism. And what we've found out is that there's been a growth in that industry over the past few years. Colleges are getting more majors, people majoring in those programs. The business owners that have been around for a while have noticed huge upticks in their business and the number of people interested in their businesses. And the ODNR, the Department of Natural Resources Division of Watercraft, has noticed an upsurge in boat registrations, particularly in non-motorboats. So the interest is growing, and it's an eco-friendly alternative, and we can make some money and have some fun at the same time.
Out of this project, I realized that there is a lot more resources in this area than I thought there were. We're just in Southeast Ohio, but we're so lucky to have so much natural geography. We learned from this project that this part of the state, has natural formations that the other part of the state doesn't, because this part of the state was not glaciated, which means we have a lot of more natural rock formations, which lends itself to the shape of the river and the depth of the river, so people are able to navigate it more thoroughly. And especially because of the recent recession, people are realizing that if we go back to our natural resources, we can find a lot more spurts for money in the area. So people are starting to get into kayaking. People are learning how to run a business. So we have an increase in canoe liveries in the area. We actually have two, the Hocking Hills and the Hocking Valley canoe livery. And also in scuba diving in the area, we have natural quarries up near Columbus. And we have a scuba shop in Nelsonville where people can learn how to get into scuba, and they can actually take trips out to Costa Rica or Australia and learn to scuba dive there. And there's actually a few different types of scuba diving, which I had no idea. So, I guess I learned that there's a lot more to this area than we thought.
We did a project basically just on the Hocking River and to inform the public just where their water comes from and how it's treated, because a lot of people don't think about that. And so we started the upstream Hocking in the Logan area, and pretty much all the cities kind of have the same process of how they get their water from aquifers, and then they treat the water pretty much the same ways, and all of them kind of have outdated equipment, and they're looking to do upgrades.
Athens gets its water from the Buried Valley Aquifer, and it has three well fields. So basically, the water will come from the Hocking, and it'll go through sand and gravel outwash, and it'll deposit into well fields that are buried under the ground. And we'll take that water and we'll stream it through pipes to the water treatment plant on West State Street.
My name's Lorraine McCosker. I work as the Outreach Coordinator in Environmental Studies, and I also coordinate the Canal Environmental Education Project. And essentially that project has involved around 60 faculty from the Athens and regional campuses to learn about environmental and sustainability literacy, and then integrate these materials into their courses. And it's a way to provide this information to undergraduates and some graduate students. So our first year, Bernhard Debatin and Ellen Gerl were involved in the process, and they went on to write an 1804 grant and create this class, which is environmental and science journalism. So we were really happy. Bernhard taught this the first year around coal, and Ellen has worked on it from a water perspective, and it's a regional look. So when we're talking about sustainability, it's really important to look at the regional approach. Other colleagues in this have been Michelle Maroney, who's the Director of Environmental Studies. She first wrote an 1804 grant to fund the project, as well as an NSF grant. And the second and third years, this was funded by the Ohio EPA. We are now going on to expand it with further grants. And in fact, this next week, we're training people from Southwest Ohio on this exact approach. 21 faculty from the Southwestern Ohio Council for Higher Ed.